What's going on, dudes, boys and girls, friends and viewers, people who I do know and those I still do not. My name is Kolosalus, welcome back to another Heroes of the Storm video, and hopefully this one goes well. I've not been happy with the quality of my commentary over the last few days of my Heroes of the Storm videos. That's why you have not been seeing them. I know I've been kind of lazy. I've been lazy with them. I just don't like the commentary that I do. Like, I sometimes just cut out and I just don't talk there for like 2 minutes. I'm really focusing on the game. I think that's actually the streaming getting into me. If you've not been following the stream, I've been actually on a very nice kind of a winning streak. We've been winning more than we've been losing. Actually, about like 80% win rate for a little bit now. And yeah, but today we'll be talking about Zul'jin. I have a pile of heroes that piled up, basically new heroes. So I have Zul'jin and Ragnaros to go over, kind of new heroes that came out and I've not even touched them. Valira is just around the corner and I've not touched him. This is a sustained assassin. He came out very, very recently, I think 3 weeks ago. One of the fastest releases basically between Valira and Zul'jin. Only 3 weeks between them. But when he first came in, he was really bad. But now people are actually starting to figure him out. I'm still not that person, but I know, I think, somehow how to play him. So let's try him and let's see how he fares against some quick match bastards. I won't say bitches, but that would be too rude. Bastards. Make way for the bad guy. All right. Boys and girls, find ourselves on the Sky Temple map. One of my least favorite maps in the entire rotation right now. On level 1, we are going to go for You Want Axe? You want Axe? That's what he says, I think. Anyway, his skill ability is a straight line skill shot in front of me. Basically, I can... Zul'jin throws an axe, dealing 130 damage, so it's very light damage, and first two enemies hit, and marking them for 8 seconds. Marked enemies take 50% bonus damage from Zul'jin's next 3 basic attacks against them. Which is kind of like a follow-through kind of ability. I very, very much enjoy it. It's good for brushing down a target's kind of like in the world of a sustained assassin. W ability is called Twin Cleave. It's a very weird, you can see, weird skill shot. Let's see, can we see anybody? It basically hits people and then it slows them for up to 30%. There we go. I can kind of punish them here with that slow. I think, yeah. Yeah, our Zerto just went over his head. Actually, our entire team is going over their heads. I saw Nova. Is this Nova? It is Nova. The enemy team has Nova in their team. Yeah, so it hits them. It's kind of like it's good for like chasing people because it slows them and also deals a little bit of damage. Our ability is called Regeneration. I can kind of like sit down for a little bit. Yeah, that's Nova. So there you go. I'm gonna sit down for a little bit, just gonna regenerate 25% of my health. Of course, this does get interrupted if I take damage or I do get displaced or anything. Anybody even blows on me, this gets interrupted. But on the other hand, we also have our D, which is called Berserker. Basically, whenever I activate this. Actually activated here, you can see that the tattoos on our body start to glow, and it actually has two effects. Every single basic attack will reduce our health by 2%, basically putting us down, but also we also have a passive kind of like with that trait. A passive with that trait is that we will be attacking 1% faster for every 1% of our maximum health missing. How good is that? That sounds pretty cool to me, man. There we go. We kind of blew this motherfucker right up, man. Yeah! So, Zul'jin is a very, very high damage sustain assassin. If he can land his skill shots, if he can... Like not me right there, I just can't hit anything. Like the enemy Zul'jin, for example, he can hit some skill shots. He should be able to take a lot out of the enemy team. And right now I'm kind of sitting in a sweet spot where I can kind of like hit a little bit faster. Of course, less health we're gonna have, we're gonna attack for like with a more attack speed. Where are you going? Where you going? Where you going? Where you going, mate? You gonna die? Oh, he's not gonna die. That's fine. That's still good. That's still okay. Still okay. Kill Zul'jin. Whoop! Whoop! Kill him! Yes! Got him. Zul'jin's fun. Zul'jin's fun. I feel like he's one of those heroes like Alarak for me. That... Whenever I started playing him, I really was playing him very badly because I just did not know how to play him with that. But now, I don't say I'm Gucci, but I'm definitely better than I was before. I'm gonna try to start a step. Oh, okay, well, she just wants to turn around and die, which is fine. Fine to me. Ziggity zigzag, ziggity zigzag, zigzag. And we picked up a talent right here, the Troll's Blood, which increases our healing by 75%. It's not our maximum health, it's 75%. Of the actual existing healing, which I kind of calculated to be around 43%, so almost a 50% heal, you know, kind of like on a very low cooldown, kind of a high mana cost though. I wonder if our Q can destroy creep. I'm not sure if I hit it though. Our W definitely can. I mean, it's a very very expensive way of destroying the creep. But it's still okay. We're gonna go back. We need some mana. The enemy team is brawling in the top lane. That's how they're doing. Not doing too bad. Not doing too bad. We're gonna go for Vicious Assault on this level range. Vicious Assault will allow us to increase the number of kind of like bonus attack damage basic attacks against the marked targets to 6, which is crazy. And then basic attacks against afflicted heroes reduce the cooldown of Grievous Throw by 2 seconds. I'm actually in the middle of a wave, so I can't do too much. This is a good zigzag cigar. I need this globe. Okay, I destroyed her creep. So my Q doesn't work on her creep. I don't think. Maybe I just didn't hit it yet. Maybe I'm just very bad at hitting my. There we go. I hit that one. Yellow. I need some help with this ziggity zigzag cigar because I can't do it. Nothing against him. Yeah, so the Q doesn't work on it. Okay. That's good to know. I mean, I have not played him enough yet to actually to know that. Should be a kill on this ziggity zigzag cigar if... okay. Our Falstead is just like ranted. He's like, nah, man. I'm just don't want to kill that ziggity zigzag cigar. I'm not sure why I'm saying that so many times. So, one tricky thing about this character is you have to know when you want to use your trait. I might want to use it here a little bit, maybe I'm actually gonna actually take some damage from the towers themselves. To start attacking faster. What are you popping, man? What are you popping? I got that Nova, I got you, but oh shit! They got me. I think this is, we can still turn around for a... Yes, yes, we can definitely kill this butcher. He just cleaved the ground, killed the Nova behind Zerto. He was actually aiming for the Zerto. That was so funny. On this level range, do we want to go guillotine now? I feel like this Dingo is a great heroic, but it just makes me play very, very ballsy and not cautious at all. I don't know about this. Ooh, very nice here, locking down the enemy Sylvanas. Kind of allowing maybe his cooldowns to get... Oh my god, one for one right there. Alright, we're gonna go for... this Dingo. I cannot just move into the objective, I mean, it is a 4v3 right at this moment. I'm gonna wait for Nova to scout it a little bit for us. It's like, it's Ziggity Zigzag Zagara and... Oh fucking shit. Okay, now it's Butcher. So we just get out of here, boys. Do something. No, we can't. It's a 4v3, my friend. I'm not here just to die. I'm here to do something more with my life. You know what I mean? Let's activate our trait here to increase our attack speed a little bit, at least. Again, I'm kind of like a passive now whenever I play quick matches. Like a... let's kill this. Oh, I missed everything. I mean, sure, so that's how a Tazdingo works. Basically, Tazdingo makes you unkillable for a very, very short amount of time. I think it's like 4 seconds, which is not that short, actually. But makes you unkillable, of course. Unkillable, it is meant... I don't think I can kill her. But Sylvanas is doing actually quite a lot of work. What? Come back here. Oh man, this butcher doesn't want to die. It's fine. So basically, yeah, I turn it on and then I cannot be killed. I cannot be reduced below one health. And basically, you know, if you guys have been listening to me rumbling about Troll, the only Troll addition to the game, you know that he actually attacks faster for every single percent of his health missing. How's that good? Well, it's good. Oh, shitballs. Oh my god, Nova, you're good at this game. Triple Fab for the win. Alright, we're going to go for, I think, Forest Medicine. I think is good. Activate to remove all recurrent root and slow. I don't think we have any roots on the enemy team. Movement speed is good for chasing, but it's not that good. Overall, yeah, I'm going to Forest Medicine. I think when we actually pop Tazdingo and we start walking away, we just activate that mofo. I think it's going to be good. So basically what this does, the Forest Medicine, basically it allows us to move while we channel. But again, taking damage or any kind of like any stun or anything like that, of course, it's also on damage. Ooh, whoa. Fancy. Fancy kills on that there too. Nice job. Looks like we're going to grab a bottom, no problem. And yeah. So what's Zul'jin's place on team? Very good question. I don't know myself. Actually, I do. It's a sustained assassin. He's supposed to kind of like either wait for opportunity to actually to catch somebody off guard, basically very, very low, very, very low, or kind of like, or actually just start getting people low so the burst damage can finish them off. That's the one of the most important things you can actually remember about the sustained assassins. That's what they do. That's what they're designed for. I think he actually does it pretty well. He's kind of a rainer on drugs, kind of in that sense. He has a very nice kind of follow through effect. The magic of the temple sweeps. Oh, I didn't get my Tazdingo off. Nice fucking gus, bro. That was good. Just save me. Ball's dead. Just saved the shit out of me. Thank you so much, man. Alright, I'm away to kill these guys, maybe, if we are safe. Alright, they didn't get this, but Nova! Still here, looks like he's gonna pop Tazdingo. Ooh, I don't know what the fuck that was. There we go. So we it just kind of worked out at the end and we were able to pick up a double kill on the enemy team with the help of the friendly Zeratul. I completely missed that grape. That was on purpose. I wanted this Zeratul to shine. I think we're gonna go for sort of swirling death here. Basically, after the first kind of like, you know, the kind of like the first rotation of the axis, you know, the axis that I throw. They're gonna keep spinning for the second rotation, which is pretty cool. Of course, it does a little bit more damage. Where is the actual Nova? The actual Nova is somewhere here. Are you guys dead? I want to see the Nova. Where's? God damn it. I'm fine, thank you. Whoop. Oh shit. Fuck off, mate! I don't want nothing of your shit. Run! Okay, we're good. I think we're good. Oh. Fuck you, Nova. I ain't got nothing on you. Actually, you ain't got nothing on me, I'm sorry. Hopefully the enemy team is not gonna rotate here and kill our hammer. Seems very probable. Like, this butcher is alive and he's hungry for that hammer booty. Okay, she's kinda ugly. I can't lie. Alright, the enemy team does pick up a camp as well. She just balanced out the bottom lane quite nicely. We did actually end up kind of on the same spot as the enemy team. Friendly hammer, a little bit of a bad spot. We do get a very nice... can we do something here? I don't know. That's a lot of burst. It's just like a lot of burst. Get out of here, man. Nobody likes your shit. Just gonna activate my regeneration here. Again, I can channel it now while actually moving, which helps a lot. Helps a lot with the survivability. We don't actually have to be stationary. We can kind of like keep getting away. Just gonna go into Tazdingo, that's fine, just back off. Kill this guy. Kill him!
Oh no! I was pressing my R so hard, but it didn't matter because I was stunned.
Friendly team is cleaning up, actually, looks like. No, looks like we're getting cleaned up.
That's the end of your killing spree.
How am I doing here? Bonus attack damage 26. Progress 2 out of 5 stacks. I'm doing terrible on stacks right here, boys. I've not been practicing with this character too much, although it seems like it's actually quite close. So how does it say 2 out of 5 stacks? I don't understand. And it's actually more than a half here. I don't get it, man. But yeah, so basically what you have to do is every 5 basic attacks against heroes increases Zul'jin's basic attack damage by 1.5. After attacking heroes 120 times, his attack range is increased by 20%, which obviously makes it just makes him kind of stay a little safer. As long as he can stack. I've not been doing this too well this game. Again, I'm gonna say this again. I've not been practicing with Zul'jin all that much at all. I'm gonna try to kind of punch the Zagara maybe here a little bit. I can stack up with this. Ooh, whoa! Is that a kill? Yeah, that's a kill. Oh god.
Later, bitches!
Oh my god.
The Stingo, you bitches!
I still killed the Sylvanas who got the mind control on me, but so it was 1-for-1. Enemy troll is going with the Dingo as well. We're gonna go for Amani's resilience here. Basically, we're gonna be healing for a little bit of the damage that we take while on Dingo, which is obviously very good. You know, it just gives that additional boost of survivability. Of course, people will start to stop to focus you when you focus as Dingo, but you know, just kind of like kind of just automatic reaction. But still, if you take any damage, maybe like a triple tap. There you go. It's gonna heal you for I think like 50% of the damage you take or something. Yeah, there you go. 50% of the damage you take, you're gonna regenerate as health after the actual Dust Dingo is done. Obviously, really, really good. Looks like we are taking the only objective of the game over. This looks okay. We have everything under control. We are getting our first keep of the game right now. The enemy team is almost all dead. Actually, two people are alive. Nova and Sylvanas. Which are now raising from the dead as well. Our force is a little bit alone here. Yep, she's right here. Very nice block. Where's that Nova, though? Go get it, Nova. I believe in you. Alright, so we got this one. The friendly Nova in a little bit of trouble right there. Oh baby, that's a triple right there. God damn, why is there nobody helping me right here? I was trying to make it such a nice play, but he had the healing of his trait on him. And I just couldn't do anything. I mean, I have to move away from him, right? At some point. I mean, the friendly team just kind of split, and we just didn't do anything at the end. I should have gotten help. I mean, that was a very, very good void prison. I'm gonna lie, it was a very good void prison, but there's just no follow-up. I mean, the butcher kept chasing me, and I mean, when I just get engaged on like that, just there's no tomorrow. No tomorrow for me at all. We're maxing out damage in the entire game, but it doesn't actually matter if we're not achieving anything, right? The stats don't matter that much. Enemy Tazdingo pushing up in the top lane. Our Nova a little bit of trouble here, but she's going to be fine. She's going to be just fine with the protection of our core. Enemy team taking the middle keep like it's nobody's business. I'm going to be back in about 2 seconds. And we are back in the fight. Tazdingo is still on cooldown though. Very, very low cooldown. Well, let's repulse then. Let's triple tap. That's actually gonna kill him, actually, I think. Nope, because it was blocked by somebody. Oh, there we go. There's still a kill here on the enemy butcher. So we do trade that one for one. That should be a kill on the enemy Sylvanas. There we go. I'm gonna actually activate my regeneration here to get some health back. I don't know, but whenever I'm like kind of like below kind of half health, I don't feel safe as Zul'jin. I know it's how you're supposed to be. You're supposed to be sitting at that sweet spot of half health, but I don't know. I just don't feel comfortable whenever playing that kind of playstyle, especially in quick match, right? Like, there's barely ever like any. Oh God, what is this knight doing right now? There's barely ever supports and barely ever a warrior, so it's like it's not safe to do anything like that ever. Kind of stay behind a certain threshold of health. I do need help here. I don't know what the friendly duo team is doing right now. Hello? Well, hello there. My name is Zul'jin. I like to kill people. Okay. I'm just gonna solo it. I'm gonna try to solo it. Probably not the best idea to actually to reduce my health right now. That was terrible. What I can actually do right now? We did lose our Nova, but we did kill Zul'jin. Not sure how to do that. Okay, I'm gonna kind of dip out here. Dip out so they don't deal damage to me. There we go. And I'm gonna just dip out here. Get a little bit of that health back. Of course, with the increased health, we will be pretty much getting the entire health bar. What? Our core? I know our core is there. Our core is fine. Ziggity zigzag zagar can't do shit about our core. I'm just gonna get this and get the flip out, get the last show. Oh, well I kind of fucked up there with the Cubis, but. Whoa, shit! Can I do something against her? Return to I can't do anything. I mean, I can only kill the Sylvanas. Sylvanas got killed, but then it's just way too much damage. Way too much damage, and they can kind of stop focusing me for a little second while I'm unkillable, and then just kind of one shot me afterwards. Which is what they're doing. Progress 2 out of 5 stacks. What does that mean? Do I have the full stacks now? I think so, right? Yeah, I do have the full stacks. So how does I have, right, so 2 per 10 times 12. So I need what, 24 stacks or something? Is that how it works? 1.5. Again, let's do the math here. After attacking heroes 120 times, 5 basic attacks per stack. Yeah, I think we've definitely done it now. We've done it by now. Okay, so we are done after doing very, very complicated maths of 1 plus 2. I'm now concluded that we are finished with our quest. And we need to take the objective. We need to do the objective.
Objective right now. Come on, go.
We can actually win the game if they don't respond to it fast enough. I do have Tazdingo up, which means fucking minion. Get out of here, boy. Oh shit balls. That was the worst void prison I've seen all year.
Your Burst him down! 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 Does dingo, bitches! Yeah, got him! Oh no! Is that game? Is that game? Why is Fawcett not there? Why is Fawcett not there? He flew, he destroyed the minions, but then he actually didn't take the thing itself? Next level mind control? I mean, she's dead anyway, right? She's not dead! No! Get on to the point! The point! No! No, I just lost the game!
Anyway, you guys saw how Zul'jin works without any kind of supporting or actually any kind of team play at all. That was just the best example of quick match I can ever give you, where people just kind of run off in their own directions, not really know what the hell's going on, don't do objectives. I just feel like playing bronze whenever I play quick match. But yeah, Zul'jin is a very, very, I think he's a good hero. I think he's a very viable pick right now in the meta, especially, you know, with the Rhaegar kind of like a self-heal Morales. I heard she's actually very good with him with the Stim Drone, of course, you know, when he actually goes into Dingo. We are actually not top damage in the entire game, but we are there, kind of just lingering behind the enemy Nova. She did some nice work, although she was terrible. She did some nice work. Let's go over the town build again. I'm not sure if this is the best town build. It's been working for me. It's been working great for me. I heard that... I mean, you can go for, like, let the killing begin. But... let's be honest here. In a quick match scenario, right? In a quick match scenario, you actually need a lot more healing. Like, there's no supports. There's no... if you have a support in your game, go ahead. Go for the let the killing begin. But again, I had no supports in the game, so I have to go for that a little bit of that additional regeneration out of the fight. But again, let's just go over the build again. You want Axe on level 1, increasing our basic attack damage. Basically, this is what we are focusing on. This is what we are maxing out. I might in the future potentially go over some other builds, like, you know, like the cooldown of Twin Blades, and that also we have some ability power when we're below 50%. There's some nice, very arguable but nice combo with the level 10 guillotine, but we shall check it out at a later date. But in this video, you want Axe, kind of increasing our kind of going all in on the basic attacks. Level 4, kind of more regeneration because, of course, no supports. Level 7, we did go for the Vicious Assault. I think it's the best talent in the tier. Just allows you to do so much damage. 6 attacks is a lot when you're doing 50% more damage, especially when you also have Yuan's Axe. And I don't think any of these two are actually good, because on this one, you actually have to be below 50%, which, again, you don't want to be at that for any time. Like, for any longer than about 3 seconds. And you're not going to do too much in that. Of course, you know, this could kind of make you better while Tazdingo, but again, you're just kind of now falling into the trap of relying on Tazdingo a little bit too much. So again, Vicious Assault, I think, is the best right now. Plus, it also reduces the cooldown of your Q, so you can just kind of keep using it. On level 10, I did go for Tazdingo. I think it's a better choice right now, but on the other hand, Guillotine makes you play a little safer. I think it's a good choice when you're trying to learn Zul'jin. Like, I might be able to pick it up a couple of times when I'll be streaming, you know, just to kind of maybe get a feel for the character. Not overextend too much. Don't play ballsy because I know I can become unkillable for 4 seconds. Just kind of be more careful, a little bit more composed. So Guillotine is that. It basically launches a massive axe, kind of like a W from Chromie. It's very similar to how it works. It, you know, it's after a very short delay, it hits, you know, it's not instant. And also deals more damage, kind of dependent on his missing health. So the more missing health he has, the more damage it's going to do. On level 13, we did go for the Forest Medicine. Again, we didn't have a healer, and we wanted to... we didn't want to kind of like dip out of the fight and just sit in the bush and just heal. We wanted to actually move while we're doing this. Maybe actually reposition, maybe mount up, other stuff. So again, Forest Medicine is good. I had Zul'jin. It's definitely a very, very good choice if you do have a support. Again, when you do have a support, your regeneration is not going to be used that much. Probably in only in the early game. In the late game, of course, when your support is not with you, then sure. But the chances are, most of the time, you're going to be a carry for your team, which means support is going to be right there next to you, almost the entire team babysitting you. So, again, no support, more forest medicine. The support, Eye of Zul'jin, just kind of allows you to chase your targets. The 16, we did go for Swirling Death. I do believe this is the only good talent here. Twin Cleaves acts as cycle twice and can hit enemies on each revolution, but its cooldown is increased by 4 seconds. It's really up to you. It's really up to you. Swirling Death is good. The Lacerate is good for the additional slow. Ferocity increases the on attack speed bonus of Berserker by 40%. It's okay. I mean, it's really up to your preference what you pick here. I just prefer the Swirling Death. I think it actually does quite significant damage. And actually, if it's basically rotating about its arc twice, then it's raining some havoc in the enemy team, potentially applying some nice CC and also applying some more damage. And level 20, we did go for Amine Resilience. And Snare is a very bad choice because of the cleanse. Of course, cleanse is a thing in the game. Crystal, just burst healing is just super strong. It's also a root. It's not a stun or anything like that. It's a two-second root, which I guess could be good. But it's a skill shot. It's not a point and click. You know, being this a skill shot also is kind of makes it hard to land, but it could be good. There are situations where it could be good. You could just trap somebody, kind of, you know, because you have your, let's say from level 1, you have your increased range. You'll be able to hit them, they won't be able to hit you if they're not someone like a Ranger or a Sergeant Hammer, you know what I mean? So, again, a snare could be good just in a certain situation where it kind of maybe like a quick match scenario. When there is no support and it's just havoc all the way, team deathmatch kind of thing. When you're playing on like a little bit more advanced scenario, okay, maybe Hero League, Team League, maybe you're even going to think about competitive, I think Amani Resilience, Aurora Basso are the ways to go. Amani Resilience obviously very, very good for your just overall survivability, right? Allowing you to just stay healthy, even if you took a lot of damage while you're testing go. And also Basso, kind of just dealing a little bit more damage. I don't think it's good talent at all. It just does damage and good in that sense. It's ability damage, so you might be able to increase it with, I'm just saying. Anyway, this has been Zul'jin. Hope you guys enjoyed this video. It wasn't the best gameplay I could have gotten, but it was definitely something. I'm actually much, much more happy with my commentary this video than any other I tried to record over the past week. And hope you guys enjoyed it too. So again, thank you guys for watching. I'll see you guys next one.